I am Chris Menard. Let's take a look at the take function in Microsoft Excel. You would use the take function to possibly figure out what is the average or the total for the last 3 months. And the last 3 months are always changing. In the past, we have used the offset function for this. The offset function will still work, by the way. But let's dive into the take function right now. So before I begin, just to show you this, in column A and B, I've got this data. I clicked in it. I did Control T to make it a table. And then I named the table TBL underscore rev. You don't have to make it TBL underscore rev, but I do encourage you to make it a table with Control T. So I want to know what is the last 3 months, the total, if I do equal sum. And I highlight the 14, 24, and 28 down below and press Enter. I get the number 66. That is fine and wonderful, except until I start adding April 2026 and whatever revenue number that is, then I better remember to go and fix my Excel function. And plus, I could accidentally select instead of 3 cells, 2 cells, or 4. Easy to make mistakes. So let's use the take function in here, equal take. I'm going to select the revenue column, comma. The second argument is the number of rows. If I do the number 3, I'm going to get the first 3 rows, 11, 11, and 10. And that is what I got right there. That is actually correct, except I want the last 3. So I'm going to do negative 3 instead of positive 3, 14, 24, and 28. You can look down below in cells B, 14 to 16, and see that that's correct. And now I will wrap this in the sum function. Right here, there is your answer. I will do a formula text, just if you want to try to keep up with this. There is the formulas that I used or functions that I used over here. Now, if I want the average, this one's going to be easy. I'm in cell F2. Let's use the keyboard shortcut Control Quotes. That copies whatever is directly above it. So now we got the equal sum again. And I'm going to just change this to average. Still got a negative 3 in there, and I get 22. Highlight those 3 numbers, 14, 24, and 28. The average is 22 in my status bar. And down below, the sum is the number 66. Perfect right there. Now, if we start adding in data, if I put in April 2026, and I'm going to make this number 36. Notice that my total went to 88 and my average went to 29.33. One more quick check, 29.33 and 88. Very good. It's working. I'm just going to do quickly 2 more months. Let's do 40 and June 48. Another tip for you. If you want to make this a little more dynamic, instead of doing, I did 3 months, but what if I'm in a meeting or a Teams meeting, a Zoom meeting, it doesn't matter. And someone says, Chris, you did 3 months. Can we look at 4 months, 5 months, 6 months? Well, I got to keep doing a lot of editing. So I'm going to highlight and do an insert at the top. And let's just shift these down. I'm going to type in the word months, put in the number 3 in cell F1. And then I'm going to edit the formula. Instead of negative 3, we're going to do negative F1. And now it is dynamic. I'll march this. I'm going to change the 3 to 4, change it to 5, and finally change it to the number 6. 190 for 6 months and 31.67. If I highlight these numbers, 6 months, 31.67, and 190 is the sum. Everything is working correctly. One more bonus tip for you right now. What if you're looking at, want to see 3 months, 4 months, 5 months, 6 months, but you want to see them all at the same time? I could do a data table, which is not the same as a table. But if I'm just looking at 3, 4, 5, and 6, I typed them straight down here in column E. I'm going to go over to F, and let's say I want to know the average, the take function, same steps, highlight, comma, how many rows. Instead of negative 3, I'm going to do negative E6. That is 41.33. Crosshairs, auto fill down. Our check figure is the months of six at the top, 31.67, 31.67. Let's just go 5 months and then 4 months and then finally 3 months. I just want to check everything seems to be working correctly. This file will be available for you to download. I'm going to do a blog post about it. Appreciate your time. My online training is available in Teams, Excel, OneNote, and Copilot. Thank you. Have a great day.